smudging. Okay, so I'll just do a quick one. I won't want to talk much, just to test our the quality of what we are doing. I won't talk much, so that it won't take our time. Sorry, I'm badging into another file entirely different from the one we are doing. Okay, different from the one we are doing. Okay, so now go to your file, open a new folder, then you pick an image from the folder you have on ground already. Okay, now let me be using this woman, Chioma Akpota. She's an artist. So, like, not a drama artist actually. Then we unlock it. Then the first thing you do is you duplicate your layer. The reason is because in case you have an error here, you can come back to your layer and pick the original image compared to the image you click. Then here, you will make this one to be zero. So you this symbol, the eyes that indicate the eyes, that is the visibility of the layer, you uncheck it, so the visibility is off. Then you come to this place. No, do let's use the normal way. Come to your pen tool, that you come here, pen tool, or you click P to select your pen tool, zoom out your image. Before we do that, sorry, click here this, then Control Alt I to check your image size. Your resolution is 72. That's too small. So we're using a resolution of 300, which is the standard resolution for images to see the picture very well. Can you see? Now the picture is clearer. It's a bit clearer than the other one. So then we move to using our pen tool. I will use pen tool to pick out the one we don't want. Then we come here, I will click, don't worry, we are done in a bit. This is a late night walk. Click, then I will click. Continue like that. Click this. Just see as I'm clicking my stuff, trying to pick it one after the other around the edge of the image. Then continue like that. That till we pick the image, finish, then this, just make sure that your images are picked well, then like this, continue like this. Like this. You continue downward. It might look bored, but you're actually arriving at something. I should have speed this one up. I will not speed it up because it's actually part of what we needed to get. So though there are other tutorials for this actually. For the sake of a perfect work, I will not be giving tutorial for this. I hope you learn from here. So if you're a starter on this, then you will find it a bit difficult. to court. But if you're a pro, oh my brothers, I have some geniuses. What are they? Yeah, they are just two genius for me. People are willing to learn actually. So okay. Oh sorry. So from there, come out. Just treat anyhow. Sorry for me. Then select, press, or come here and pick your quick selection to. Then right click, then layer via cut. Can you see that? You can see some white edges here. That means this background has been cut away from the image. So when I click on the background, it's gone and the image is perfect. Now you can see that the delete it, you have nothing to do with it. You can see that the image is clean, the edges. That's the work of the pen tool. When you use the pen tool, it gives you a clean image and all. So from here, we've duplicated our layer. Then from here, we'll go to image. Then we'll go to adjustments. From the adjustment, we go to light, shadow, and light. Can you see it lighting it up? We don't want it to light up, so we reduce one to 7%, and we do this one to 5%. Then we click it. Now you can see, look at it. See this? Can you see the difference? When it's not there, the edited one, unedited, edited, unedited, edited. So from here, since we already do it like this, then the next thing we have to do is now Control J or duplicate, right click, duplicate layer. When you duplicate layer, then you come to your normal. That's your the blending mode for the layer. So you put it to linear light. See this upon yo-yo. So that's a Yoruba name actually, upon yo-yo. So we from here, then we come to filter, then we come to order eye pass. When you put the eye pass, then put my eye pass to 3.5. So you see, can you see the cleanness? Let me zoom it out, zoom it in. Can you see? Look at the image, zoom it in. Now let me try to see the image here. Let me put out the, can you see how clean it is? So this one gives you a kind of a detailed of the image. Normally every masking we have a pause, so that the pause is showing, but because they powder the face, can you see everything is looking clean? But this one showed the what's it called, the original statue, original face shape, no face nature. Anyhow, okay, so sorry, we are not grouping. We control E this. Then after that, the next thing is to start smudging, but we are not going to start smudging now. We still want to adjust some things there. Then the next thing is for us to come to our pen tool. Either you click P or you pick it directly. I think you should know what pen tool is used for now. Then the next thing is you want to remove these eyelashes and eyebrow. Want to remove the bro, the latches, blah 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 blah. So I don't have much to say here. Actually, just keep looking at the screen while I do it. Keep looking at the screen. Some of you that have my that know me on Instagram, you should have seen one of this. You should have seen this picture. Eyelid. Can you see? So I think I've cut out the necessary part. Then time to smudge. Now I'll be using, this is my, the smudge I'm using, then my smudge brush. I'll be posting the smudge brush link on the WhatsApp group. Now this is the brush I'm using, my smudge. It's on 30 actually. Now I will enlarge it to see, and I'm going to increase what I'm doing to actually see what I want to smooth. Now, before smoothing, you have to control this, control J to duplicate it. Then you will mask it into the one you duplicated. The reason being that when you are smoothing, let me show you what I'm saying. Now look at this one now. Look at this one. If I smooth here, I smooth it out. Come in. Now, if I should, let me say, I smooth this out. Yeah, I smooth it. Can you see my smoothing? Now, this is what I smooth. If I should remove this, I take it off. If I should take it off, like I'll move it, I release the layer mask. Can you see? Smooth it outside. When I put the layer mask there, to turn it back inside. That's just the essence of the smooth, so of the masking it there. So let's leave it like that. Then let me duplicate again and let me layer mask layer. Now let's now start smoothing while we are here. So I'll start up. You will see how the eyes, the face, the texture, how it goes. You can see there's light here. Some places are light, while some are bed. They put some makeups and it's lighter. Why some is a reflection, why some are dark. So the darker one, you smooth it together, the light one, you smooth it together. The reason is because when you can't expect to bring a light work and put on black, it will look so much scattered and all. So what you do is you just smooth the black one to this side, to the black, and you smooth the light to the light. So when you still get to where you are going to blend, so when you are blending together, it will be easy for you to do. So let's go. Can you see what I'm saying? So it's going small, small. So you look at it very well. You reduce. This is where you now start using your brush, increasing your brush, and all and all and all and all like that. Sorry. Let me check my brush. I'm using a smooth brush. Yes, I'm using a smooth brush. Then I will increase it. Then I will come here. Still smudging. Still smudging. Can you see that this place is lighter than this? This place lighter than this place? So you continue like that. You keep releasing your mouse to make sure that everything you are doing works well. Keep releasing your mouse, reducing the size, increasing the size of your smooth object where you are smoothing. This is too dark. This is too light from what we are doing before. The reason is because the eye patch we put is too much. So you see what we are passing through. Why? Because our light is too much. So the light we pass is too much. So is too much. So when you are doing your own, it's possible you reduce the eye pass so that your smudging will not give you issue. Why smudging? So continue. You know what smudging is now, so you continue like this. It takes time, but it's worth it. And you can see it's looking nice now. It's looking nice. It's coming out well. So then this. Just maintain your the silent and maintaining here while I do what I need to do. And after I'm done with all this, I will try to blend it for you guys to see. Yeah. Don't mind me. Yeah, this was what I did for someone and the client saw me working on it. I was like, wow. I got a work from this actually. Got work, worked, framed people, did it myself. Just practice, practice, practice. Sure you are doing this neat. That when you bring it out, people will be able to see that this work is fine, neat, and work towards perfection actually. Don't start a work and after you watch one tutorial video, you now go and say you're not a professional. Don't go express on someone's work. You know the work, you not take it easy with you. My brother. So yes. So now, I think let me try to start. I won't take much of our time. Let me try to blend this. Blending doesn't take long. Yeah, blending doesn't take long. I'm not blending it yet too. I'm still smoothing it because I see that some places are okay. Now to blend, return your brush, your strength of your smooth brush to 15 or any number you want depending on you actually. So now this one, you blend this and you blend this with this. You're blending, you don't need any other place pattern to go, just make sure you and keep blending. We want to blend the white part into the dark part and the dark part into the white part. That's what we want to do when we come, when we're talking about blending, so it will look real, like a real picture. Look, when you look at yourself in the mirror, you see that you have some places that are light in your faces, some are dark, some places looking rough. So, and there is a what can I call it, there is a correlation between them all. So that's what we call this now. Looking smooth, but to me, okay. I'm coming. Let me pause the video and check something. Let me pause the video. Okay, welcome back. Now from here, then I think, then I can try, just decide to do the body anyhow I want it, because the body has no definite pattern. Then put it to 50 because I told my hair pass is much. So if I put it to 50, then I try to smudge this part. It should be fast. The reason that is my hair pass is what caused the structure that we are having. My hair pass is too much. See that? Let me increase it to 60. Everything like this. You'll be seeing some skin reactions when you are doing your work. That's why you work. The day you are doing it, keep checking it out to see where the dents are coming from. I think I'm seeing some, so I'm just trying to adjust it so that they won't spoil our labor. Is okay. The next one we'll be doing, we'll be reducing the high pass. You can decide to remove the high pass yourself if you want to remove it. You can decide to remove the high pass yourself. So before you start, or maybe I didn't talk about the iPass in the beginning. So maybe when you see that, okay, I'm not liking what I'm doing, then you can use the iPass. Then for blending, I can increase my brush. I blend this together, make it look real. Make it look real. So make it look real. Make it look real. Yeah, I'll be teaching you. I posted some link to download some plugins for Photoshop. I'll be teaching us how to use those plugins the next time we'll be meeting. So now that we are done with this, it might not look as fine as the other one I did. I just did this one, the quick one. I don't want to waste our time. So I did this. Now, using Photoshop CC 2019, you cannot do what I want to do now on Photoshop CC 2019. You must have Photoshop CSS on your system, so that when you want to do it, you use CSS and use CC 2019. This 2019 can do all this. When it comes to oil painting, which is this I want to do, oil painting, the CC 2019 cannot do it. Only CSS can do it. So that is why I'm using CSS for my tutorial. At some point I was like, I want to get 2019, I think is okay, fine. But I get to see that 2019 is, we are just hyping it actually. There's nothing all those ones want to do that one cannot do. So you can decide to freestyle with your style, your oil paint. I had to put it very big to make it look somehow real. You can use the shininess, you want to shine very well. Then when you're okay to see the effect on your system. Sorry, it's taking long. My system is full. So now you see what we are seeing here. Let's do for the air also. I think the air one is now, because I already customized the oil paint. Immediately I click it, it brings it automatically. Then I can customize it like that. So when my air comes out, it comes out like a cartooned air. That's the work of the oil paint. It makes it all come like a cartoon one. Can you see it? Look at it. Compared to this former one. Can you see? Can you see it? Can you see it? Good. So the earring also. I'm not going to change anything. I'll just be adding everything like that. I'm not going to change anything. Just be adding everything like that. I think I love the texture I'm seeing here. Look like all these Cinderella, this. A beer like that. I think I'm doing what I'm seeing. So let my head do. The earring is done. The eyebrow. Oil paint also for the eyebrow. That's this one. This one to also change to look like a cartoon small one. Yeah, I look fine. Your picture is looking fine. Thank you. It's a cartoon work, my brother. So from here, fine. Picasso, how do you call that? I don't know, but just then you click everything and you control E to make it one. Then you will power clip it into this one. Then you come to your smooth brush and your opacity doesn't tend to be your strength. Now you can see these edges, it's looking as if they carry this air and put it on this skin. So we don't need to be like that. So we'll now blend this air with this skin. That's what we want to do now. So you take your blending tool, then now start blending. Then you start blending. Shall just make sure that Let me share that. Then put to 60. Okay, I think this one is still the one here. Okay. Then here. Then. Blend it. Can you see? I'm blending it. Then you blend it with each other. Still blend. Can you see? It's already taken off, taken care of. So you blend it with each other. Make it blend well. Make it blend well, blend well. Blend well. Blend well, blend well. Then you come here. Try to blend this one with the hair. So, this one too. This one too, blend it well. Just blend this one well. Make it look real. You see, okay? Now see, they brought the hair from heaven. So, come to this one also. Blend this one. Then you come to this place. And you blend this together. Then can you see? Already working out. So just make sure that the traces, there's no trace of what the there's no trace of, you don't have to do this one. It's as if they draw the eyes. So you see, just make sure that there's no traces. We are working with just two layers now, the body and the then lower this, the eyes too needs to be adjusted. Do the eyes, and come here also, and do this one also. A quick one for that. Yeah, let's go. Okay. Then I cannot put the three images together and control E everything. That's it. Look at the original picture. See the original picture. See the detailed one. See the original. See the detailed one. See the original. See the detailed one. Can you see? So from here you cannot get an E. You can get a background that you now put. Put gradients. No. Gradients. I'm gonna put this. See, can I increase this? Something like this. Cut the saw.